Welcome to Moo Moo Math and Cellular Respiration and Photosynthesis. Wouldn't it be nice if you could take the exhaust of your car and use it as fuel for your motorcycle, and the exhaust of the motorcycle and use it as fuel for your car? You would have a nice cycle in which both the car and the motorcycle benefit. Photosynthesis and respiration have a similar type relationship. The product of photosynthesis is used in the chemical reaction of cellular respiration, and the product of cellular respiration is used in photosynthesis. Let's first learn about photosynthesis and cellular respiration. So important. In order to stay alive, we need to eat food. Do these plants also need food? Yes, but how do they get food by just standing around in the sunlight all day? Plants get their food in a process called photosynthesis. In order for photosynthesis to take place, a plant needs three things. Water, like you see in this rainstorm. Carbon dioxide, like you see being released into the atmosphere when something burns. And light. Here's how it works. Plants have small openings called stomata. Carbon dioxide from the atmosphere enters the plants through the stomata. Each plant cell are small organelles called chloroplasts. Here's a short video of some chloroplasts. Photosynthesis occurs at the chloroplast. Plants take carbon dioxide plus water with energy from the sun or light, and in a chemical reaction, kind of like this explosion, create sugar and oxygen. The sugar created in this chemical reaction called photosynthesis becomes the plant's food, and the oxygen is released into the atmosphere. So here is a definition of photosynthesis: the process in which plants combine carbon dioxide and water along with light energy in order to create sugar and oxygen. Living things practice cellular respiration. This includes bacteria, fungi, plants, and animals. But why is cellular respiration important? It is important because living organisms generate energy for daily activities with cellular respiration. In plants and animals, cellular respiration takes place at the mitochondria. Think of the mitochondria as a power plant for the cell, because the energy of the cell is generated at the mitochondria. Just like these power plants and turbines in this video generate power for their city. Cells that need more energy have more mitochondria, like muscles. At the mitochondria, the sugar combines with oxygen to produce carbon dioxide plus water and energy in the form of ATP. Now, photosynthesis takes carbon dioxide and water with sunlight and makes sugar and oxygen. This happens to be exactly what cellular respiration needs. So at the mitochondria, this sugar is combined with oxygen to make carbon dioxide and water along with ATP. And this cycle repeats over and over again. Thanks for watching Cellular Respiration and Photosynthesis. Moomoo Math uploads a new math, science, or motivation video every day. Thanks for watching.